something more starts to be a bit Is it a bird or a bird? It's not supposed to do this. I definitely need a new one for Porto. So I am going to teach you how to do it without it doing this. We need to buy this special lightweight material. Here am I! In the US and Canada, the material you find is white, and in France it's more a clear material, but that's a difference of culture. I am not sure you can find a white one in France and a clear one in US and Canada, but whatever, never mind the color. The important is what you can do with it, a folding board for your urban sketching practice. So the material we use is called coroplast or alveolar polypropylene or alveolar polycarbonate, but that's the same material. Maybe you saw in the previous shot that mine is 4 millimeters thick, and so you buy a sheet a bit this size, and then you cut it to make your folding board. It's been a little while since I offered a tutorial, so I'm really happy to make a new one today. Plus I won't make any during my trip in Porto and Lisbon because I will be so busy creating, so that's nice to make it today. If you are not familiar with my folding board concept, the idea is not carrying a whole sketchbook with you because it's so much weight. A whole sketchbook with a lot of pages plus a cover make a lot of weight in your bag, and if you want, like me, sometimes painting standing while carrying your sketchbook, the weight is even more bothering. So the idea is to bind only a few pages together like that. I have some tutorials about making your whole sketchbook, so feel free to check them. I will make a lot of links in the description box below for you. So you bind only a few pages together, and then you use this folding board as a sort of a temporary cover, which is really lightweight and that you can use over and over again with your several pieces of sketchbooks. And at the end, after sketching or painting on your pieces of sketchbook, you bind them together and make a whole big fat sketchbook, which can be landscape orientation or portrait and of every size you like. By the way, feel free to also check my urban sketching setup video where I explain all my tricks and tips and magical strategies for urban sketching, drawing and painting on location made easy with not so much gear but a lot of pleasure and excitement to create. First step, cutting some pieces of this big thing, and first we are going to measure to have it the right size and the right direction. Because I made mine with some leftover of the coroplast sheet, and this was not the right direction, you can see that the lines are vertical, and because the cover is longer that direction, you have more risk to have it bend it that way, and look what happened. Wow, really rubbish. Whereas if I put the line the other direction, which will mean that the coroplast will be that way, I absolutely won't be able to bend it this direction, so this will be just like that. Haha, please give a thumbs up if you already like the video. Plus I also think that cutting it that direction is a thing that creates some problems here, and that make it bend a bit both direction. But as you want this to carry your sketchbook, you want of course, to be able to fold it, but you want it to stay flat when you have your sketchbook at the top, so I'm going to show you how I do it.
So to make it simple, we are going to measure the size of the board depending on the size of your sketchbook, and we are going to put the line of the material the longer direction of the cover, so they will be vertical if you put your rectangle vertically, and the line will be horizontal if you put this horizontally, which is just the reverse that what I did for this one using my leftovers. By the way, because the material is made to create veranda roofs, it has a UV side, which means that when they put a veranda, they have to put this the right side so that the material is not going to change the color, but we don't really care, so just put it the direction you like.
The first time I bought some, it was not so obvious that it was some kind of plastic protecting the materials, so at some point I was wondering if it was damaged, but this is just a sort of protection plastic that you can remove afterwards. I am going to let it that way for now so that it can protect a bit the materials, and I will remove it at the end before taping my pieces together.
I am going to make a landscape board, but once again, even if you make a portrait one, just cut the material the same direction as me, only the spine will be different, but the two pieces for the front and the back will be the exact same as me.
So we said we want the vertical line the direction of the cover, the longer direction, so I'm going to cut a piece like that, and there is not enough room in here to make another one, so I will cut the other one to the side and then also the spine. To cut the pieces the right size, I recommend for the width that you cut almost the same width as your sketchbook, which means not more rooms to the side. The reason is because normally you don't really need some room to the side, and if you have some wind and you need to clip your paper to the side of the board, it's nice to have the side of the paper really close, whereas if you make your board larger like that, you can clip your paper that way, but not to the side. So I check the width of my sketchbook and I just add a teeny teeny bit, but almost nothing. Once again, if you need more info about the dimension of the sketchbook and everything, just please check my tutorials about it. And for the height, if you use like me some kind of bulldog clips to put your palette and everything, you need a bit more room at the top. So mine work like this, as I showed you in the urban sketch scene setup video. So I need at least the height of the bulldog clips in addition to the height of the sketchbook for the dimensions of the board. I cut this one pretty tight, it can depend on the bag you want to use to make it fit inside, but I think I am going to make the new one just a bit slightly taller, because I'm going to carry it in a Chicago or a Porto bag like that, just a regular tote bag, so it will be easy to fit in the bag that direction or even the other one.
So just make your measurement and report it on the material. Mine is going to be 28.7 centimeters by 22, sorry for the centimeters. Keep in mind that it's always easier to cut it shorter if you need it, so when in doubt, just choose a bit larger rather than the opposite.
Blade! You'll see there is one direction when it's easy to cut, when you follow the direction of the structure of the material. In fact, you just have to cut this thin thing and the thinner thing underneath. It's more tedious when you cut the other direction, because you sort of have to cut every little kind of barrier in between, so it makes when you cut it, and it's a bit more difficult. For the cutting, please follow the direction I gave you for the sketchbook cover. When cutting the cardboard, just start with not too much pressure, just a light touch, and then you can go harder and harder when the crease is created. As the material can be a bit difficult to cut, especially when you are the opposite side of the line and to the edge, feel free to ask someone if you don't have a lot of strength to do it, so ask for help, or take your time and make some breaks if you need it to make it by yourself. Ta-da!
So we all have two similar pieces together. If you want to make a portrait sketchbook, you are going to create a spine that is this height, and if like me you want to create a landscape board, you are going to cut a spine that is this height. About the width, you don't need much because the idea is that your piece of sketchbook is really thin. So the only thing is that too thin can be difficult to handle, so we need a kind of minimal thickness, but you can make it a bit the width you like depending on the piece of sketchbook, the kind of paper you use, everything. About the direction, once again, I recommend that you cut your spine that direction, which means the same direction of the line, and it's going to be easier to cut rather than cutting it the other direction, because in this direction the material is more likely to bend and you don't want your spine to bend. So I think it seems to be a better choice to make it that direction. So just measure the height of the spine you need and cut a bit of the width you need. Something you may want to take into consideration is once again the structure of the material. Because of the alveolar structure, a good idea would be to cut it just in here, for example, to have kind of a limit, and maybe making two things. It's a bit bigger than I was thinking, but I'm going to try it with two little boxes and see how it goes. So my spine is 22 centimeters long by two alveoles. I am not sure yet if it's the right choice or if I will find it too wide. I figure out, I always try to improve and to try something else, so we'll see how it goes. Now, to put together your folding board, step one, remove the plastic protection, if there is one. Step two, tape the inside of the folding board. For the tape, I don't recommend any masking tape that wouldn't hold really well. As my material is transparent, I usually try to use some transparent tape so that it doesn't show. So you can use this. And you can also use even stronger tape like a fabric tape if you feel like you need something stronger. In the inside of the folding board, tape really tightly the back and the front of the cover with the spine.
So try to put them really, really close. Oh, that's pretty on these lines. It would deserve a photo. So yeah, really, really tight like that. You can even slightly bend your cover while taping it, so be sure it's not going to bend the other way like I showed you with my current one. Remember, we want to avoid this.
I'm going to put my additional palette underneath to the side so that it's slightly bended in here when taping it. Other side. Normally it stays rather flat. And then we are going to tape the other side of the cover exactly the same way we taped the cover for the sketchbook. And this is a board and not a cover, and I said a cover, but that's kind of the same.
So put your cover like that and make the tape create an angle following all this path. Exactly the same than for the cover. Putting your board between your knees while doing it is an option.
So put your tape at the top and then make it follow the crease.
Tape both sides, of course, as the tape doesn't hold really well in the little trim, you know, of the board. It makes a bit of a tape nose sometimes, but I guess that's not the end of the world. The main thing is that it stays flat. So I trim all tape which is too long, but then, because sometimes the material once cut can hurt a bit the finger, I put a tape all along the edges to a bit of protect you to hurt yourself. So you just tape a piece of tape like that and the other side, you know, to cover all the edges. Then in the outside of the cover, just cut the tape you just added with a blade so that you can open and fold your folding board again. If not, this tape is going to block you to open it, but now it works again.
Then the final touch is adding some kind of closure for your folding board so that you can close and open it really easily. I am using some tape Velcro.
As you can see on my old board, so this is this kind of material that can go together to stick and open and close really easily. So one side is just taped on the front cover, and the other side I use a piece of ribbon that I attach to the back cover with the same technique we use to attach the ribbon to the cover. So you can check Indian sketchbook tutorial to see how I fold the ribbon so that you are sure it's not going to go away, and then you tape the piece of Velcro the other side to be able to close it.
As for me, I kind of lost my Velcro tape leftovers, so I'm going to buy some this week, but I will probably have already released this tutorial, hopefully, by then, so that's why I'm not showing it to you. But it's really easy to do, just put one piece in front, the ribbon to the back, and then you fold the ribbon in order to have the two pieces that goes really well together. This is really simple but really lightweight and so handy. I am so happy I have a new folding board to bring with me to attend the Urban Sketcher Symposium this year in Porto. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. Please tell me if you follow it to make your own folding board and what you thought about it. Subscribe if you haven't already for more understandable, helpful art-related tutorials, along with some art vlogs and a lot of inspiring creative content, hopefully. Feel free to give a nice blue thumbs up to the video if you find it helpful. I give you a big creative hug and see you!